Welcome back to the channel. This is 8-bit days a week, and we're gonna play Destruction Derby on a PlayStation Classic. Now here's another game that I think gets a lot of hate because you're including a Psygnosis game, and the first game, of course, that would come to mind is Wipeout. And why there isn't a single Wipeout here is really putting off a lot of people from buying this console, of course. Destruction Derby is it's not bad, but we're not even getting the better version of Destruction Derby, which is part two, for me at least, I think for a lot of people. Anyway, I did have fun with this game. Let's see if I could still remember how to play this. Okay, of course. Can we actually do this on the classic? Doubt it though. Alright. Wrecking Race. Destruction Derby. Came out at the time where, you know, at least they're trying new stuff, because I don't think there were any other games similar to this one where you have to, where the point is really to crush all the other cars. It was usually your standard racing game. Or if there was some sort of, if there was like a competitive element other than the race, it was using, you know, if you're trying to hit other racers, it's usually used by the use of weapons, not like this, in this manner. Plays okay. But it's this is more of a mindless fun kind of game. So, you know, I don't care if I lose. No strategy. Go out there and ram everybody. Race over. Yeah, this game is okay. It's just, I think everyone is just bitter about why this instead of Wipeout. Or why not both, you know? And if they chose this series, why the first one? Because obviously they're not really choosing like the first entry to the series, because we have Tekken 3 and R4, which are sequels. And if I'm not mistaken, there's like three. Was it four? I think there's just three Destruction Derby games on the PlayStation 1. And sadly, after that, I think this series never had anything new anymore. Maybe because, I don't know, I'm not sure what happened to Psygnosis. I think they were bought out by some other... Was it by Sony? I think it was Sony who got them. I can't really remember. So in a way, this feels like a really unpolished version of Daytona from Sega, except this one has a actual, you can actually get your car totaled, unlike in Daytona where even flip over how many times you're still running. Slower though, but you're still running. You have to take the pit lane. This one doesn't have any pit lane, of course. But in Daytona, there is always that sense of satisfaction of flipping your opponent's cars. At least that's how I have my fun in the arcades before. There. I was in front of it already. Well, that's too bad. This is where a rewind feature would have been useful. But sadly, the PlayStation Classic doesn't have anything like that. Alright, we've tried Wrecking Racing and Destruction Derby, so might as well try this one. Yeah, I suppose this is more like the Daytona racing version of this game. To get me, making sure I don't get the first place. Feels like they're all up against me. And you'd notice that this game doesn't feature anything like transmission, manual or automatic. So it's more like go-karts. You just have a gas pedal and a brake. I also play this a lot on the PC. Yeah, I seem to play a lot on the PC before, because I guess my friends usually have some copy of the game. They borrowed it. Because I remember playing this in the Tomb Raider, another PlayStation, well-known PlayStation title. What else was it? MDK. I played most of these on those games on the PC, actually. Although my PC before was just like a Pentium 100 or... or 133. It's not really the best setup, but it was still fun. Thinking about it now, it feels stupid to be playing like games that appears to be made for consoles on the PC. During that time, I guess today it's a normal thing already. Most of the PS4, Xbox One titles get Steam releases. Maybe they should do that as well. I wonder if the PC versions of those games are in GOG. Huh. Just try one more destruction derby. Let's go. Let's see how long I survive this time. To find the camera options, when I seem to be stuck on this view. I'm beginning to wonder if I'm misremembering things, because I'm pretty sure there was options to change the view here. Oh, there, see, I can do a zoom. Oh, there it is, I finally found it. Like this view. Dizzying, isn't it? Well, at least we're getting decent frame rates here, as opposed to the other games. And, okay. Well, overall, this game is a frustrating inclusion. I suppose it's okay if you like the Destruction Derby series, and it's not really that bad, but just once again, there's like a better option out there, and I don't see any, like for example, a licensing issue. It's just they chose poorly. Not to say you're not going to have fun with this game. It still should provide you with some amusement. And that's it. I mean, that's what's important. I'll be playing this some more. But for this video, that should be it. This is 8-bit days a week. And please do leave a subscribe, comment, like, and you all know those already, probably hear that too much already. And please do catch me on the next few videos. Thank you for watching.